Breaking up with sign in with Facebook, a step-by-step guide. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Hey, if you're not signed up for my weekly newsletter, Confident Computing, go visit askleo.com/newsletter and sign up today. More tips, tricks, and answers like this one every week. Here's the question. Okay, I get it. Don't use Facebook or Google to sign in. But here's an unanswered question. How do you recover from this error? If you've already did this move at a website, as I unfortunately have, how do you undo it? Do you just establish another login and don't use Facebook Google link again? Or is it just too late because Facebook and Google already has your info and just continue using Facebook or Google to sign in? Well, certainly Facebook or Google have the information that you've provided so far, and there's really nothing you can do about that. That horse has left the barn. However, you can avoid continuing to give them even more information by undoing this, by disconnecting your account from Facebook. Let's go ahead and walk through that. I'll show you where to find what it is you're looking for and what you can do once you get there. So here we are over on my Facebook account. I'm going to go ahead and go to a special URL in Facebook settings. You can see here it's in the companion article for this, so you don't have to type it in, but it's the applications tab on the settings page. When you go to that, you will find something called apps and websites. This is a list of those sites where you have used sign in with Facebook. Google has an equivalent URL, and that too is available in the companion article for this video. Now, I don't have anything listed here because I went through this exercise when I wrote the article. I've actually disconnected all of the applications that showed up here, and there were a lot. I strongly suggest, even if you don't plan on making any changes, that you visit this page so you can see all of the connections you may not realize you have. For each of those connections, you will have the opportunity to remove them. And that's what I suggest you do for any of these services that you really don't want to have associated with Facebook as the login. Now, what happens when you do that? Well, unfortunately, that's going to depend a lot on the specific service. Here's the thing. That service will have at least gotten your email address, the email address that you use for Facebook. You may still have an account with that service using that email address, and you may just need to do a password reset. Again, not using login by Facebook, but actually using that service's email and password login approach. That might work. Unfortunately, I can't say that all services are going to work that way. It is very possible that it would be a completely different account and you'd be starting over from scratch. The important thing here is to understand what's going to happen before you make this disconnect, because if you've got a lot of investment in this specific account, and disconnecting login with Facebook would basically render that lost, then don't do that. Make sure you understand what's going to happen. On the other hand, if it really doesn't matter, or if it is the same account, then by all means, feel free to do so. There is one scenario that is unfortunate that really we can't do anything about. And those are those services where login with Facebook or login with Google or login with some other third-party service are the only option. They don't have their own login approach. They don't have an ability to log in with an email and password. They are reliant on these third-party logins. In which case, well, honestly, there's nothing really you can do. Now, there is one other thing I want to point out here, and that is what I refer to in the article as the big hammer. Back over on Facebook, like I said, normally there would be a list of applications here that you can disconnect one at a time. If you scroll down a little bit further, you'll see that under preference, there's this thing called apps, websites, and games. Now, you have the option of turning it off. What this will do is actually prevent this from being an option for you in the future. If you try to log in with Facebook, it will tell you you have this turned off. Now, they will offer to turn it on again for you should you go down that path, but it is a good reminder that that will, in fact, turn this feature back on completely. Now, you'll notice I don't have it turned off. I have it turned on. And that's because, as it turned out, when I turned this feature off, it broke something else. There's a connection that, for whatever reason, is not currently listed here that I needed. So I needed to come back and turn this on. But in most cases, this can be a very quick, very powerful way to turn this feature off completely. If something stops working, then you can come back and make an educated decision. I hope that helps. I hope this helps clarify exactly how you can disconnect yourself from login with Facebook. Like I said, login with Google has a similar list. The link is in the companion article for this video, which is askleo.com/163743. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.